PCOS, or polycystic ovarian syndrome, is a complex condition that affects women's ovaries. This is Mia, an 18-year-old that identifies as female. She has felt like she might have PCOS but is not sure. After some research, she learns that the pathogenesis or development of the condition is complex and includes transgenerational, genetic, and environmental aspects. There are two main causes of PCOS. First is hyperandrogenism, which is an overproduction of male hormones. And the second is insulin resistance. Glucose is a form of sugar that our body uses for fuel, and to uptake glucose, the hormone insulin is needed, kind of like a key that unlocks a door. With insulin resistance, our bodies do not respond to this insulin, and we cannot take up glucose properly. Mia sets up an appointment with her doctor, Dr. Ovary. Dr. Ovary lets Mia know that for diagnosis, there are three specific elements. To be diagnosed with PCOS, you must show two of the three elements in any combination. First is oligoanovulation, where ovulation does not occur on a regular basis and the menstrual cycle or your period is irregular. Second is either a clinical or biochemical androgen excess. Androgens are hormones that are responsible for male reproductive activity and traits. PCOS can lead to too much androgen production in women and can cause fat tissue to accumulate and dysfunction. Lastly is the ultrasound assessment of ovarian morphology, which essentially studies the structure of the ovaries. Ovaries have ovarian follicles that are small, fluid-filled sacs where an egg develops to be released during ovulation. With PCOS, follicle development and the release of a mature egg can be prevented due to abnormal hormone levels. The ultrasound can show if there are a high number of immature follicles in the ovaries, which would be considered polycystic ovaries. Mia feels a bit worried. In her family, things like menstruation are not really talked about. She doesn't know anyone with PCOS or showing any similar symptoms. In fact, no one around her really talks about this kind of stuff. Dr. Ovary understands this. She explains that there can be a lot of stigma surrounding PCOS, especially due to infertility, body hair, and obesity. However, it is important to not let PCOS define you, but embrace that it is part of you. Remember that all women are unique and come in all different sizes. PCOS affects 1 in 10 women in the reproductive age, making it the most common endocrine condition. This means that you are not alone. Women with PCOS, including yourself, need support, both emotional and social. After all, many women feel overwhelmed or distressed due to their symptoms. Finding a social circle that understands this and can support you is rewarding. There are also online support groups like www.pcoschallenge.org or social media groups that might help. Now that you know the basics of PCOS and the social stigma surrounding it, let's take a further look into the treatment of PCOS and the recent research for it. Overall, there has been a notable shift of focus from pharmaceutical-based interventions to lifestyle-based therapies. PCOS has no official complete cure. There are a variety of treatments, however, for PCOS, depending on which symptom you may want to target and improve. Making healthy choices and having a balance between the consumption of all types of food and physical activity is a method to progressively improve the symptoms of PCOS. As you have learned throughout this video, PCOS is caused by the overproduction of male hormones and resistance to insulin. Insulin resistance itself also is one of the reasons for the overproduction of androgen, so it's kind of like this vicious cycle. Now, one way to potentially treat PCOS is to find a way for our bodies to be less resistant to insulin and respond correctly when insulin is produced. One way is through medications. The glucose and insulin response involves two types of glucose transporters. A potential treatment that is currently being researched is to block these transporters in order to have control over these effects. These medications can decrease insulin levels, cause weight loss, which itself can lead to insulin sensitivity, and reduce hyperandrogenism. However, it is worth noting that weight loss is not always necessary for patients with PCOS. Therefore, blocking these transporters can cause a reduction in insulin production, which then will also lead to a reduction in male hormones. Weight gain is one of the most common symptoms of PCOS. The issue with this is that weight gain itself can lead to furthering insulin resistance. Therefore, having a balanced diet which avoids insulin overproduction is important. Research shows that having a protein-rich diet can reduce insulin production, which will then lead to a reduction in androgens. Increased consumption of nuts and fish oil have also contributed to the reduction of insulin resistance. In addition to achieving a balanced diet, having daily physical activity is also very important. As we have gone over what PCOS is, social aspects of PCOS, and treatment options for the symptoms, we now hope you have a better understanding of PCOS, just like Mia.